I was born in Mexico and migrated to the United States when I was 7 years old. I mean, I grew up in a place where there was a lot of drive-bys, a lot of shootings. A lot of my friends by the time I graduated high school were either dead or in prison. I look back and I see myself now and I said, I wouldn't have been here had it not been for people that provided those opportunities.
There's no university that really functions without having good citizens among the faculty. Erika always goes above and beyond in terms of her service in helping to diversify STEM fields, which is a major problem in the United States. She is very engaged in national professional associations that are trying to develop the pipeline, especially for minority youth going into mathematics.
So I sit in boards to create those opportunities, but also sometimes there's funding available and we're trying to decide what type of program will be the best. What type of strategies are we going to prioritize? And it's there, I think, where it comes full circle what I do for my students, because I make sure that those priorities are in line with people that need that help, people that are come from disadvantaged backgrounds. And it's those people that we need to open the door for.
I'm a first-generation college student. The first time I met Erika was in 2016. I was looking for someone to be my dissertation advisor. I knew when I met her that she was going to be my advisor. We had a meeting. She walked me through research and her expectations, but she even invited me to go into a meeting that she had with her undergraduate students. Watching her work with them let me know that I would feel comfortable working with her, and she would also prepare me as I graduate and move on.
One of my biggest time commitments is really devoted to service and serving in national boards, committees. Change is not going to happen just with a few, but when we have a critical mass. And we need to allow people that come from backgrounds where they have struggle, where there's no opportunities, to come in because they come in with a different perspective.
Problems facing the world today are wildly complex and inherently multidimensional and interdisciplinary. And in many cases, the reasons we have not yet likely come to solutions to some of the most vexing problems facing the world today is because we've had a very narrow set of minds, if you will, a very narrow part of the population addressing those.
She's just a phenomenal person who is really good at the work that she does. She works very hard, but more importantly, she cares about people. And I think that is the most important attribute. No matter what you do, how much money you make, what are you doing to leave the world better than you found it? And she does that.
So one of the reasons that I came to ASU is because the charter is who I am. That's really who I am, you know. Not only that, I believe that we are measured by who we include, not who we exclude, and the demographics of the students. The students that come to ASU are like me. So it's like I see myself in them. And especially if I'm able to mentor them and help them achieve their dreams, it really validates why I'm here.